Hey, welcome back to the channel. In today's Tutorial Tuesday, I'm going to show you how to install Linux alongside Chrome OS using Crouton. Now, this is a full-blown Linux distribution that you can toggle back and forth between Chrome OS and Linux and install all your favorite Linux applications. As usual, I'll have links down in the description to everything I talk about, and let's get into the tutorial. All right, so here we are in the Chromebook, and the first thing we need to do is reboot this into recovery so we can put it into developer mode. Super easy to do that. All you do is hit the escape, refresh, and power button. It's going to restart into that recovery mode now. All right, so this is our recovery mode, and at this point, all we need to do is hit the Control and D key to get us into the option to put it into developer mode. It's going to ask us to turn the OS verification off. When I hit Enter, when you come to this, it's going to make a loud beep unless you hit the Control D. So when you get to this screen, it's just telling you it's going to put it into developer mode. Just wait until this times out. Or if you decide you don't want to do it, go ahead and turn the computer off. But we're just going to wait it out and let it go in. So now it's setting up the developer mode. And when it boots into the operating system, we're going to have to reset everything up from scratch, just like it was a new Chromebook. All right, so after developer mode, it came up and we went through the setup. And that is the point we're at now. So we're ready to go ahead and install Crouton. The first thing we need to do is download it. So if you just go out to Chrome, look for Crouton, it's probably going to be the first item on the list. And all we need to do is go to this link and download it. While it's downloading, scroll down a little bit and you're going to see the instructions for the install, which is right here. Super easy to get this all set up. So once that's installed, all we need to do is open a terminal, and we're going to do that by hitting Control Alt T. It brings up this terminal. We can just drag this out to the other side of the screen, make it a little easier. We need to go into a shell. So just type shell in here. And then we're basically gonna just copy and paste these commands from the left side into the right side. So what this first command does is it just puts Crouton into a location that we can execute it from. Then we're gonna do sudo crouton t. Now in the instructions, it says xfce. That is a Linux desktop. You can look more on Linux desktops. There's a lot of information out there. But if you want to know which ones are available for Crouton, at this dash T, you can type list. And it'll show you all the different desktop environments that you have available for Crouton. So for the purposes of this tutorial, we are just going to do what the instructions say. We're going to install Crouton T XFCE. So what this is going to do is it is going to go and download all the files that we need. It's going to set up the chroot for us. And then when we come back, it's going to ask for a username and password. So right now I'm going to pause the video and jump ahead to the end of this installation. This does take a little while, so just be patient, but you'll see things happening on the screen so you know it's not stuck or anything. All right, so at this point, our installation is done. It's asking us for a username. So just going to type one in and then a password that we use to start this up. And that is it. The installation is done. Now, if we want to launch into that Linux session, all we need to do is do a sudo start xfce 4. So this is our xfce desktop. And for this tutorial, I'm just going to use the default configuration. You can go in and configure this however you want. Now, the first thing I would do once this is set up, this may not be necessary because it should get all the updates, but just come into a terminal. I just click down here for the terminal and run the command sudo apt update. Type in your password that you chose. It's going to go through and update the application repositories, so the database for the applications that are available. And at this point, up in this area, it would tell you if there's anything that needs to be upgraded. And if there is, you would just do sudo apt upgrade. And that just ensures that your system is up to date. But at this point, we have a fully functional Linux installation alongside of our Chrome OS. And we can switch back and forth between the two. And you do that by holding Control Alt Shift and then the left arrow to get back to Chrome OS. Now you can see on my Chromebook, when I switch back, the screen gets messed up. And a quick way to fix that is hit Control Alt right arrow, left arrow, and it refreshes the screen. Everything's good to go. And if you want to switch back to the Linux installation again, all you do is hit the Control Alt Shift, left arrow, get back, and you can switch back and forth between Chrome OS and Linux all day long. Now, if you want to exit out of here, you can just come up to the top, go to log out, and it'll exit out there, bring you back to Chrome OS. Again, I need to refresh the screen. Another way to do that is to come down to the panel here and toggle the nightlight on and off. That just refreshes the screen and gets you back up and running as well. So that's it, pretty easy, right? And at this point, you have a full Linux distribution running alongside Chrome OS that you can toggle back and forth between, install all your favorite Linux apps, including Steam, and some games that will run on your hardware. That is gonna be kind of hit and miss because of the limited hardware on Chromebooks, but it does work. Hopefully you found this useful and informative. If you like videos like this, make sure you subscribe. If you like this video in particular, hit that thumbs up and leave me down a comment below if you have any questions or comments. And I will see you in the next video. Thanks for stopping by.